also known as the Tiny Taster, and today's recipe is a wonderful, super simple, creamy, chunky mushroom dip. Now, this is the perfect recipe for a party if you're hosting, especially during New Year's, if you're not going out, or even if you're just alone and it's a party for one. It's super simple, comes together in minutes, and so, so good. If you like this video, make sure to give it a big fat like, leave me a comment, I want to know what you think. Subscribe to the channel, I got a lot more videos coming up, especially in the new year, and of course, if you haven't seen what I already have, make sure to watch some of my previous videos, and I hope you enjoy this. Happy, happy new year. I hope 2021 is fantastic for each and every one of you with lots of great food and hopefully when the world clears up, a lot of travel. So happy new year. I hope you enjoy, and without further ado, let's get cooking. For this recipe, you're going to need some finely chopped mushrooms. I've used just button mushrooms, but if you like, you could use a mix, porcini, enoki, anything you like. You'll need salt, pepper, a chopped onion. You'll need some flavoring agents. I've used chili flakes and oregano. You'll need some shredded cheese. I've used mozzarella and a little bit of fresh cream. In a pan, add a bit of oil and a knob of butter and toss in your chopped onions. Cook them gently for about a minute or so till they turn nice and translucent. Once the onions have cooked, you toss in your mushrooms. You could add it bit by bit if you like, if they're too many, or you could just add it all at one time, it's no problem. Mix it well together so it coats well and starts cooking with the onions. After the mushrooms have cooked for about 2 minutes, you want to add in your salt, your pepper, your red chili flakes and oregano. You can also add in any other herbs that you like. I actually like to add in some fresh garlic as well. I actually just forgot it, but I would have otherwise. It gives it a nice crunch and texture. So you can add some garlic as well and mix it all together and let this cook till the mushrooms start to sweat a little or release some moisture. It doesn't really take very long for this to cook, about a couple of minutes, and you'll start to notice that the mushrooms release a little bit of water or moisture. That happens once you add salt to it. If it releases too much water, you might want to crank up the heat a little bit, but honestly, it doesn't make much of a difference. Once you start seeing the water releasing, you want to add in your processed cheese. I've used shredded cheese just because it's easier, but you could use cube cheese and just cut it into pieces. It's not a problem. Any cheese that melts and that you like to eat, just add that in. You'll notice the cheese starting to melt quite quickly and it starts sticking in. This is a great time to add in your cream. The cream really just helps loosen it up so the cheese doesn't become stick and become too clumpy with the mushrooms. If you want, you could even add a little bit of water to thin it out, but just about 2 tablespoons of cream is more than enough. If you do feel that whilst you're mixing the mixture still needs a little bit more cream, of course you can add it. I didn't. About 2-2.5 tablespoons was more than enough for this recipe. So this is really it. This is the last stage. Once you've added the cream, it barely takes a couple of seconds to just melt and mix it through. And then when it's nice and hot, you just transfer it into your serving bowl or platter. And you could serve this up with some nice chips. I'm obsessed with these baked wafers. I just think they're wonderful and so yum. So I've added that, but you could do anything. You could serve it with lavash or pita chips or even on little toast and make a little crostini out of it. You could also add them into canapes like I have, and they make for great party snacks. So it's not necessarily a dip, but it's like a little filling for these canape holders. It's really quite versatile. You could add some garnish to this as well, chopped coriander or parsley. You can mix it up, jazz it up, put 3 cheeses. Really, the choice is yours. So I hope you've enjoyed this recipe. It's a wonderful party snack and it makes for great leftovers for breakfast the next morning. Hope you enjoy this. Make sure to like this video, leave me a comment, and of course, subscribe to the channel. I'll see you guys in the new year. Happy, happy new year. I hope 2021 is fantastic and oh so delicious. I'll see you guys soon.